More people than usual walked inside the George W. Bush Presidential Library and Museum. We found Reggie Franklin and his wife Yvette signing an official guest book.
I didn't even know he had passed when I woke this morning, my husband told me. And it's on such a sad and somber occasion, but I'm just glad to be here.
The Franklin family was already planning today's trip, visiting from Houston home to the Bush family. They actually met former First Lady Barbara Bush when her husband was in the hospital.
I ran into Barbara Bush when he was in the hospital several years ago and got a chance to meet her when she was still healthy and alive. And so just a great family, nice family.
Their close relationship on full display. The museum is filled with time tickers of accomplishments and contributions to our nation. A room full of several pictures of the 41st, father to the 43rd.
That's why they're all smiling.
That's where we met the Zukowski family from Michigan.
George H.W. Bush was the 41st and George W. Bush was the 43rd.
Did you learn that in school?
My mom.
Our friend Perry here had already arranged that we were going to come this morning, and obviously with the death of George H.W. Bush, it just intensified our desire to be here more.
I'm a part of George W.'s generation, and I have lots and lots of admiration for George H.W. because of the fact that he's a part of my dad's generation, the ones that that brought us through World War II, and that was no small accomplishment.
That service was an early sign of the public service that was yet to come, many referring to him as the most successful one-term president, the best dad ever, a shining star here in Texas. Cleo Green, Channel 8 News.
And if you'd like to honor the late president, you can visit the George W. Bush Presidential Center tomorrow, beginning at noon. There, they have a special display where you can pay your respects to the family. And if you want to visit the Presidential Center in College Station, it opens at noon tomorrow and at 9:30 the rest of the week. Now, we will, of course, stay on this story all week long. We'll have the latest right here on WFAA News, and you can read more about the president's life and legacy on WFAA.com.